Enterobius vermicularis, commonly known as the pinworm. This parasite belongs to kingdom Animalia, subkingdom Metazoa, phylum Nematoda, family Oxyuridae, genus Enterobius, species Enterobius vermicularis. The parasite named as the pinworm because posterior end is sharp and pointed, which looks like a pin. This parasite, formerly known as the Oxyuris vermicularis, the word meaning of Oxyuris means sharp tail. It is more common in the school children under 18 years and primary caretakers of the infected children. First identified by the Lucard in 1865. Human are the definitive host and lives in the large intestine, especially cecum, appendix and ascending colon. Morphology. It has three morphological forms: ova, larva and adult worm. Adult worm has male and female variety. Let us study about the ova. Shape: plano-convex, size 50 to 60 micron into 15 to 30 micron, color non-bile, eggshell thin transparent double layer, ovum embryonated with a tadpole larva. It flows in the saturated salt solution. In this picture you can see the ova size and double layer of the eggshell. Adult worm, you can see the size and posterior end of the male and female adult worm. Common features of the adult worm: rounded shape, anterior end does not have buccal cavity and presence of wing-like structure called as a cervical allay. Posterior end is pointed. Posterior end of the esophagus is dilated, looks like a bulb called esophageal bulb. This picture you can see the cervical allay and esophageal bulb. This picture you can see the posterior end of the female worm. Difference between male and female worm: size of the male worm 2 to 5 mm and 8 to 13 mm in case of female worm. Posterior end is coiled in case of male and straight in case of female. Genitals present in the posterior end in case of males and present in middle one third in case of female adult worm. This picture you can see the posterior end of the male and female worm. You can see the posterior end of the male worm. You can see the posterior end of the female worm. Life cycle: infected form, embryonated egg containing tadpole larva. The source of infections are contaminated fingers, bedcloth, food and drinks. Autoinfection, which means a person can reinfect themselves from their own. Retroinfection, which means mature egg with larva hatches in anal area and migrate into the large intestine to become the mature worm. Some of the source of infection materials are contaminated food and drinks, towel, hand, dress, blankets and cobath. The life cycle begins when the host exposure to the source of infections by ingestion. Eggshell of ova will dissolve by the digestive juice and larva comes out. Then the larva hatches in the small intestine and migrate into the large intestine. Develop into male and female worm in large intestine and perform copulations. Male dies immediately after copulation and gravid female migrate to anus at night. Gravid female worm liberates the egg in the perianal skin. The immature larva become mature within 4 to 6 weeks and contaminate the food and drinks, towel, hands, dress and blankets, etc. When the new host will exposure to the above source of infections, the repetition of the life cycle occur. Pathogenesis. The pathogenesis are inflammation, ulceration and submucosal abscess in the intestinal mucosa. Eosinophilic and lymphocytic infiltration, ulceration and granuloma formation are the extra-intestinal lesions. Clinical features: pruritus anae, nocturnal enuresis, insomnia, restlessness, abdominal pain and weight loss. The complications are urethritis, appendicitis, endometriosis, salpingitis, vulvovaginitis. Diagnosis: perianal swab at night, NIH swab, cellophone tape method. Perianal swab helps to identify the ova of Enterobius vermicularis. In this picture you can see the ova of Enterobius vermicularis and also see the female worm which liberates the egg. NIH swab helps to collect and examination of the Enterobius egg. You can see the Enterobius egg. Cellophane tape method. Enterobius eggs are collected by the clear cellulose tape from the perianal skin and identified through the microscope. You can see the numerous egg in the cellulose tape. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to Pathology and Microbiology classes of NIH.